Good day, Basic 4 pupils. Today on mathematics, we are looking at squares and square roots. Squares and square roots. What are squares? Squares are gotten by a whole number multiplying itself. Squares are gotten when a whole number multiplies itself. When a whole number multiplies itself. Examples. One times one equals to one. So one square is what? One. That means one square is equals to one. Power two is the symbol for square. Power two is the symbol for square. If you write a number, and for example, a put power two, that means a square. The square of what? A. So, to get the square of 2 now, or 2 times 2 is equals to 4. It therefore means that 2 square is equals to 4. 2 square equals to 4. Let's try 3. 3 times 3 is equals to 9. It therefore means that 3 square is 9. 4 times 4 is 16. It therefore means that 4 square is 16. 5 times 5 is 25. It therefore means that 5 square is equals to 25, and so on. Therefore, squares of numbers are 1. Squares are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, and so on. So we have told you that to get square of any number, you multiply that number by itself. If I want to get the square of 10, it means 10 times 10, which is equals to what? 100. Let's put x here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9, that's one digit. 10 is two digits, so we'll stop at 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So cover up. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Then I told you how to get multiples. The multiples of one, just adding one. 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. Multiples of 2. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 2, 16, 16 plus 2, 18. Go to 3. Multiple of 3, start with 3. 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 3, 15, 15 plus 3, 18, 18 plus 3, 21, 21 plus 3, 24, 24 plus 3, 27. Let's go to the multiples of 4. 4, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 8, 12, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 4, 16, plus 4, 20, plus 4, 24, plus 4, 28, plus 4, 32, plus 4, 36. Go to multiples of 5. Plus 8, 16, plus 8, 24, plus 8, 32, plus 8, 40, plus 8, 48, plus 8, 56, plus 8, we have 64, plus 8, we have 72. Then, we go over to 9. Now, we start with 9, 9 plus 9, 18, plus 9, 27, plus 9, 36, plus 9, 45, plus 9, 54, plus 9, 63, plus 9, 72, plus 9, 81. So to get the square, if I say 1 square,
1 times 1 equals to 1, that is a square. 2 times 2 equals to 4. 3 times 3 equals to 9. 4 times 4 equals to 16. If you look at this number straight, they are all what? They are all what? Squares of numbers. So 5 times 5 is 25. 6 times 6 is 36. 7 times 7 is 49. 8 times 8 is 64. And 9 times 9 is 81. So it is only these numbers that are squares of numbers. Others are not squares of numbers. Others are what? Not squares of numbers. So 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, and 81 are squares of numbers. Square of 1 is 1. Square of 2 is 4. Square of 3 is 9. Square of 4 is 16. Square of 5 is 25. Square of 6 is 36. Square of 7 is 49. Square of 8 is 64. And square of 9 is what? 81. What are perfect squares? Perfect squares are numbers that can multiply. Other numbers can multiply themselves to get that number. For example, if I say 1, 1 is a perfect square. 1 times 1 will give us 1. 2 is to say 1 is a perfect square. Let's try. 2 times 2 will give us 4. So we can say 4 is a perfect square. So before 4, we have 2. 2 is not the perfect square because there is no number that can multiply together that can give you 2. What about 3? 3 is not the perfect square. But 4 is the perfect square because 2 times 2 equals to what? 4. So 4 is a perfect square. So if we refer to our box, 1 is a perfect square, 4 is a perfect square, 9 is a perfect square, 16 is a perfect square, 25 is a perfect square, 36 is a perfect square, 49 is a perfect square, 64 is a perfect square, and 81 is a perfect square. All of that numbers from 1 to 100, I mean from 1 to 99, sorry, from 1 to 89, 81, apart from these numbers, they are not perfect square. All of that numbers we have in this box are not perfect square. The only perfect squares we have between 1 and 81 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Columns. Let's say, for example, if we have 1, 2, 1, 2. If you count the row, 1, 2, if you count the column, 1, 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is a perfect square. Are we there? Okay, let me say 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Is this a perfect square? Count. The row is 1, 2, 3. The column is 1, 2. It is not the perfect square. Here, we have 2 rows, 2 columns. Mind you, the horizontal is your row, while the vertical is your column. So here, it is a perfect square because the row and the column, they are 2, 2. Here, the row, we have 3 rows here. We have 3 rows here, 1, 2, 3. We have 2 columns, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2 columns, 2 columns. Sorry, we have 2 rows. We have 2 rows, sorry, we have 2 rows and 3 columns. We have 2 rows. The rows is 1, 2. 2 rows. Column 1, 2, 3. So they are not the same. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is not a perfect square. This is a perfect square. Perfect square. This is not a perfect square. Not a perfect square. So you can get a perfect square and a number that is not the perfect square by arranging them in row and column. Let's take another one. Let's take, for example, 5. 5 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's not even complete. So let's take another number. Let's take number like 8. 8. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4. So 8. How many rows do we have? We have 1, 2 rows. 2 rows. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 columns. 4 columns. They are not the same. So it is not a perfect square. Not a perfect square. Not a perfect square. Then last, let's take for example 9. 9. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 9. 1, 2, 3. We have 3 rows. 1, 2, 3. We have 3 columns. So they are the same. So we say this is a perfect square. It is a what? A perfect square. So what we mean is that perfect squares can be arranged in equal number of rows and columns. When you cannot arrange a number into equal number of rows and columns, it's said to be, it's said not to be what? A perfect square. Perfect square is this way. You start with 1. After 1 is 2. It's like a triangle. In the, at the front of 2, before 2, you put 1. At the back, you put 1. So 1 is 1, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 2 is 4. So 1 is the perfect square, 4 is the perfect square. After 2 is what? 3. What do you get before 3? 2. So put 2 here, put 2 here. What do you get before 2? 1. Put 1 here, put 1 here. Add up everything together until you get 1, 1. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 is a perfect square. The same line down, the next one you put 4. Ask yourself, what do you get before 4? 3. So put 3 here, put 3 here. What do you get before 3? 2. Put 2 here, put 2 here. Until you get 1. What do you get before 2? 1. Put 1 here, put 1 here. Add up everything together. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 2, 15. 15 plus 1, 16. So 16 is the perfect square. And so on. If you go down and put 5. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. See, it's following down. So what do you get before 5? It's 4. Put 4 here, put 4 here. What do you get before 4? It's 3. Put 3 here, put 3 here. What do you get before 3? 2. Put 2 here, put 2 here. And what do you get before 2? 1. Put 1 here, put 1 here. You see, it's following a triangle down. And all the numbers, the beginning and the end, they are all 1, 1. So add up. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. Plus 4, 19. Plus 3, 22. 23, 24, 25. So 25 is a perfect square. In other words, 5 times 5 is 25. 4 times 4 is 16. 3 times 3 is 9. 2 times 2 is 1, 4. 1 times 1 is 1. If you go down after 5 is 6, then you ask yourself, what do you get before 6 is 5? Put 5 here, put 5 here. What do you get before 5 is 4? Put 4 here, put 4 here. What do you get before 4 is 3? Put 3 here, put 3 here. What do you get before 3 is 2? Put 2 here, put 2 here. And what do you get before 2 is 1? Put 1 here, put 1 here. And you add up. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 3 is 6, plus 4 10, plus 5 15, plus 6 21, plus 5 26, plus 4 30, 33, 34, 35, 36, 36. 36 is a perfect square. 6 times 6 is 36. If you watch all of them, this forms a triangle. If you look at it, it forms a triangle. I'll call it a triangle square. Triangle square. You see, this one is not anywhere in your textbook, but I just derived them now. So you look at, and if you look at it, they all end in 1, 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1. If you follow down, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So for your activity, you are going to continue up to 10. 7, 8, 9, 10. So get the numbers before, the numbers after, the numbers before, and tell me what is the perfect square. That is activity 1.
Tell me what is the perfect square. So that is your activity one. You saw the way I did it. So from getting the numbers before it and getting the numbers after it, then you should be able to get a perfect square. How many rows has a square number of 100? 100 is what? 10 times 10. So it has 10 rows and 10 columns. So the number of rows of a square number of 100 is what? 10. How many columns has a square number of 81? This is number one. Number two. How many columns has a square number of 81? How did you get 81? 81 is what? 9 times 9 is 81. So the row is 9. The column is 9. This one is 10 rows. And this one is what? 9 columns. So you get it by the number that will times itself to get that. So one of them is row, the other one is what? Column. Activity 2, refer to your mathematics textbook. Go to page 123 and 124, exercise number 1 to 10. Exercise number 1 to 10. Thank you very much. I hope you had a wonderful time. God bless you.